This one thing helps a busy working mom like you keep a clean home. What is it? Create a simple cleaning routine. And I'm going to explain three reasons why this is the best tip for you. Number one, it breaks tasks into manageable chunks. You don't have a lot of time as a working mom, or you have so many responsibilities. Aside from the responsibilities that you have at work, there are the responsibilities with your kids, with your marriage, with your home, maybe with community service or volunteerism or with your church. And so you want to be able to do things either on a daily or a weekly basis. So in my previous video, I talked about figuring out which tasks you're going to do on a daily basis and which ones you're going to do on a weekly basis. You can go further and say even a monthly, quarterly, or a yearly, but for now we're just going to do daily and weekly. So for me, I like to do daily tasks, washing the dishes, cleaning the sink, wiping down the counters, wiping down the kitchen table. Those for sure are my daily tasks. Now, those may sound straightforward, but if those are not going to be your daily tasks, that's okay. You are cleaning your home. You're not cleaning my home. You're not cleaning your neighbor's home. It's your home. But those are tasks that I highly suggest that you get done. It just feels good to have a clean kitchen. Maybe one of those other daily tasks is cleaning the bathroom sink and the toilet in the morning. If that works for you, then that's great. I tried that for a few months and it just honestly was tiresome for me. So I went back to cleaning my bathrooms once a week, and I pick a specific day, and that day is Tuesdays. So look at your daily tasks. Maybe there are ones that you don't have to do every day. Now, you're not going to be like living in filth, but maybe you have six people or four people using the same bathroom every day, that daily cleaning your bathroom makes sense. Now for us, it was just me and my husband, or my kids had their own bathroom. So weekly, cleaning the bathroom weekly worked out for me better because of my schedule, because of my capacity and the other things that I wanted to get done in my life aside from working. And the reason you want to break down your tasks to daily and weekly is because you don't want an overwhelming task where now you have to get everything cleaned in one day or in a few short hours. But again, if that works for you, if you like to clean all day long and your schedule allows for that, and that's something that you like, you find that kind of therapeutic, then go ahead. But for me, cleaning all day on a Saturday, I felt like all my Saturdays were taken. And then once my kids started having games on Saturdays, then that was pretty much impossible. So breaking down into daily and weekly helped me a lot. And I determined which days were for cleaning. So Tuesdays was bathrooms, Wednesdays the kitchen, Thursday is the floors, and then the other days had certain other tasks. So example, also on Sunday night, which I think is part of cleaning, but also preparing for the week, I cleaned out my purse, I cleaned out my car. And when I say cleaned out, because it got to a point where it was maintenance, probably took me half an hour at the most, sometimes 20 minutes. And then I was able to do my schedule also on Sundays. So what, my suggestion is to come up with, you know, list down every area of your home. So in my home, you know, I listed out every bedroom, every bathroom, living room, family room, dining room, kitchen, and even my kitchen. I broke it down into pantry, fridge, freezer, the kitchen nook, you know, and then the sink area. And so when I would do my Wednesday kitchen, maybe some weeks I'm doing the fridge and freezer, and then, you know, kind of a light cleaning of the other areas in my kitchen. Then the next week I would focus more on the pantry and then just wipe down the fridge and freezer. And but just also one thing I want you to keep in mind is that maintenance and or cleaning your home, part of it is also includes decluttering. Now, I don't want to talk too much about decluttering here, but I have noticed, and you know, when you are more decluttered, it is a lot easier to clean. So just imagine, you know, the surface of, let's say, your kitchen table. If you have mail, homework, backpacks, you know, school uniforms, soccer practice uniforms on top of the table, you know, you're going to have to move that stuff to wipe the table, right? But if that's all clear and decluttered and everything has its place, it's going to be a lot easier to clean. So just keep that in mind. Number two, reduces clutter accumulation. So a simple cleaning routine helps you deal with clutter. If your daily task is to clean the kitchen table after dinner, and there's backpacks there, the cereal box from the morning, mail or soccer practice stuff is on the table, every day you're gonna have to take that off, wipe the table, set the table, take everything off and wipe the table. After a while, you're kind of sick of the backpacks being there or the paper stuff. So you're going to create a system because you're like, I'm going to deal with this clutter. So now the backpacks go on the hooks by the landing zone. The mail never reaches the table because now you have a process for that. And then everybody knows that the box of cereal goes back into the pantry once you're done using it in the morning. So with this daily tidying and cleaning and the weekly routines or the deeper cleaning on a weekly basis, it helps you deal with the messes more promptly. The gunk doesn't build up and you feel like the place is clean. And because of that, it snowballs and you're like, I also don't want it to be cluttered. So that's how having a simple cleaning routine reduces clutter accumulation and also saves you time. Number three, it promotes consistency. A set routine promotes that so that now you're not dealing with one overwhelming task, but it becomes part of your regular life. And then everyone is involved. So this is not just mom's job or dad's job, but it's all of our jobs because this is our home, right? And this is our environment that we want to live in and create memories. And to implement your simple cleaning routine, I would have a family meeting where we all decide how we want our home to be, how clean do we want it to be, and what that means for us individually and as a family, and why we want to have a clean home. Is it because we want to feel good in our environment? Is it because when our friends come over, we're not embarrassed, or mom and dad want to have a dinner party here and there, or friends over? Whatever it is, we discuss that as a family, and then we choose what our tasks will be so that we are taking ownership. And when each of us takes ownership, it's easier to keep ourselves accountable to the goal that we have as a family. So even for my kids, I let them choose what they wanted to do with their room. There were basic expectations like, okay, we're not going to have food piling up in here, or you've got to throw away the trash, or it has to be cleaned at least once a week. So for example, I know if there were dirty clothes on the floor, by the time they were 11, that's when they started doing their own laundry. They knew they just had to take care of their laundry, right? And I just never bothered anymore if they had clothes or towels on the floor. It's their room, it's their space, if how they wanted to feel good in that space. Now, of course, for me, I would like it to be spotless every day, all day long, right? But that was an expectation that I took away from them so that they could take ownership of their room, because that taught them responsibility. And I'm telling you, now that my kids are grown, my son has his own apartment, he's working, my daughter is in the dorms, her own place, they take ownership of their space. And so that was something that we chose to implement and it worked out for us, versus me opening their door every day and nagging, hey, pick that up, throw that away, do this, do that, make your bed. I let them have that opportunity and that choice to teach them, you do what, you know, you create your space and you live in your space. So anyway, it worked out for me. Let me know in the comments below what you think about that. I think that would be an interesting discussion because it kind of goes into a little bit of parenting, I think, and teaching responsibility and things like that. And everyone has a different point of view. I know for my own, I guess, sanity, because naturally for me, I have a little bit of a higher expectation, but I didn't want my kids' memories of growing up in this home where they couldn't live in their space. So it's a further discussion, but that's what I have to say about that for now. The other thing you can use are visual aids. So my daughter loved chore charts, very, very much loved chore charts, whether they were magnets or stickers. My son, not so much. He would look at it, he's like, okay. Like, he was not motivated by having more stickers. But my daughter loved all the stickers. I mean, her goal was to fill every spot on that chart with stickers. And so for us, we didn't really reward them for more stickers or whatever. It was kind of, we wanted to be like an intrinsic award for them, or an award just for themselves. So if my son had two stickers, that's fine. But he just knew that my one expectation is, like, at least once a week, you know, the his room is decently clean. But of course, with the other tasks, like he was in charge of throwing the trash, my daughter was in charge of putting all the dishes from dinner in by the sink, those were expected on a daily basis. Creating a simple cleaning routine is the one thing you need to maintain a clean home as a working mom. Why? Because number one, it breaks tasks into manageable chunks. You're able to deal with things on a daily or weekly basis versus having to spend a whole day cleaning. Number two, it reduces clutter accumulation because you are forced to face your space and to get rid of the clutter so that it'll be easier for you to clean. And number three, it produces consistency where the whole family can be involved and take ownership of their environment. Click the next video to create a simple laundry kit to make laundry easier.